This video and stream is proudly brought to you by whatiszs.com. Whatiszs.com is currently down at the moment for maintenance and may not be operational for about a week. Have a few problems with our provider. It will be back up and running soon, so yeah. Okay, friends, subscribers, and all you YouTubers out there, look, have I got a video for you today. What is going on at the moment is a bit of a nightmare for everybody, and I believe that you all have a right to actually know what is actually happening. And that is, I've actually found absolute proof that Google is really actually spying on us when we're not even using our phones. Our phone could be totally sitting in our pockets, and then all of a sudden Google turns around and spies on us. And how do I know this? Well, I'm going to show you, so just bear with me for 1 second, and I'm going to bring it up as soon as I get this. Sorry, I'm losing my mouse. So here's the proof. That one pink ad right there where it's got 1 million views. Right? Now, why is this absolute proof that Google is spying on us? How I know that this is absolute proof? Why in the hell am I getting this video for gabapentin? Now, gabapentin is an epileptic drug that they sometimes use for pain relief, right? Doesn't really bloody work anyhow, but they think it kills pain. I haven't seen it work for me. In fact, I turned out I was actually allergic to it. And I was actually in hospital. I got rushed to hospital again this morning. More pain in my chest, and this one they couldn't work out what was going on. And I had my phones with me, and my phone was in my pocket on the way to the ambulance and everything like that, and he's asking my allergies, and I gave him gabapentin. And I'm actually waiting to see the other one pop up and everything like that, because I went through a whole heap of drug trials and everything, and it was a bit of a shock to actually see this video. That here it is, like, I'm just talking to the ambulance in regard to my allergies and what this drug actually did to me and everything. Now, I've never made a search on this drug. Never. Not once. So why in the hell is gabapentin appearing in my search when I hit YouTube, like, to get a list of what's going on YouTube and everything like that? So it's particular that this has actually popped up. And I'm going to get the chat up. Sorry, I didn't get the chat up. Here it is, that all of a sudden this is actually appearing on my choices that I've actually got and everything like that. So if you want to comment on this, if you've had an experience with Google, jump on and let me know. Because the simple fact that here it is, like I mentioned it, first off with the ambulance driver, when they asked me my allergies. Second, in the ambulance when he was asking my allergies. Third was when we got to the hospital, the nurse came over, went through my allergies. Then fourth, the doctor came over, asked my allergies. Fifth, the cardiac doctor came over, asked me my allergies. And but it was going on and going on about it. Like, yeah, I mentioned it a few times today, gabapentin. So all of a sudden, I'm actually seeing an ad for gabapentin, or an ad for a video in YouTube. So why in the hell has it sort of jumping up here, gabapentin? It's a weird video to actually appear in YouTube. And that's bloody ridiculous, folks. And it truly is ridiculous. Here it is in the middle of my YouTube search after I just hit the word YouTube to bring up a new batch of videos to see if there was anything decent to watch. Because, as I said, I've been in hospital most of the day. And it's sort of just amazing. I'm looking at it and I'm going, huh? And it is. This is truly absolute proof. I'm actually going to be going to the government tomorrow and I'm actually going to talk to them about this, because this is wrong. We should not be being spied on by Google. This is, and to me, this is proof. A weird drug, an epileptic drug that they give out to some pain patients to try, well, actually, they trial you on them when you go to a pain clinic, and they say, oh, no, it works, it doesn't. And this is when I was telling him the story of gabapentin, what they did. I was actually in hospital once. I'd already been through all the pain clinic trials down in Sydney. And I used to go to the North Shore, and because it's actually got one of the best pain clinic doctors down there. So I went down to that pain clinic and I made sure I got a referral to that pain clinic. But I've recently gone to the pain clinic up here. And I did talk about it the other day, but only very briefly. And I don't think I actually had that phone on me. I didn't have my smartphone on me. I had just the old Windows phone with me. And I'm just chatting away with the doctor, and actually did speak in detail about it, what it actually did to me, the gabapentin. And so, because I did have an allergic reaction to it, so naturally you're going to run through all your allergies, and especially your drug allergies, because that's one of the first questions that they go through. But here's the other thing. A minute ago, I was watching another video about other drugs, and they've all popped up earlier. But then all of a sudden in this search, this one popped up, and that's when it clicked. We are being spied on. I couldn't go back to the other ones because everybody knows how you hit that YouTube button, if you hit it again or try and go back to it, it all changes, all the videos. And I just couldn't absolutely believe it, that here it is, gabapentin. I'm thinking, why the fuck is a gabapentin video doing on the thing? Then it instantly struck me. I'd been talking about it and mentioned it anywhere from 5 to 8 times today, when every time I'd spoken to a nurse or a doctor in regard to my allergies. And bang, here it is. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to do a quick buzz through this and actually have a look at other, to see if there's anything else. I haven't actually gone through this search. All I've been talking about Jesus again, because I was talking about praying. The nurse asked me what I was doing and everything, and I said I'm actually praying. And prayer videos have come up. Sometimes they do come up. Again, Sigma males. I was talking to my sister about being a Sigma male. And I was explaining how I've never had any dramas getting girls. Bang, a Sigma male appeared. And so I'm just going through. And there we go. I've been talking about how I'm going to study the Jewish religion. I'm looking at studying that. That one's appeared as well. Now, this is things that I haven't put searches in. Oh, actually, maybe the Jewish search. Yeah, I did put a Jewish search, but I didn't put it into YouTube. So just let me go through anything else. I've been talking about the River Euphrates a fair bit. That's come up a few times today. Naturally, the Bible's been popping up a lot. So it's just, There we go. Hermits, final. My sister and I were talking about being... Because I actually enjoy living on my own. And she said, oh, someone said about the hermit down the end of the road. And I said, yeah, I know it's me. Because I pretty much don't like company coming around. I ignore my neighbours because half of them are idiots anyhow. And I'm not saying which ones. But, yeah, so bang, there's a hermit video pops up. I've been talking about, I've done videos about that, so that would actually appear. And, that's something else, just other things going wrong. Power bills, there we go, there's another one. An energy company. I was on the phone to the energy company, 2 days ago. I was on the phone to the energy company. I've never done a search in regard to energy. And it's just beyond a joke. Here we go. In this one Windows thing, all these things are popping up. Why? Because my phone is listening to me. And there's another Sigma video. So it's just a matter of, do it. Talk about something away from YouTube. Don't do a search, something you haven't searched YouTube or Google for. And maybe something you're allergic to. Just talk about it to somebody in your own home. But make sure your smartphone is there. Because then all of a sudden, I guarantee you, you are going to see these things popping up and everything, because it's just absolutely amazing. Here's another one. Someone asked me what my favorite song is. There's that one as well, because we were talking about music. There we go. Every Praise is, and that truly is my favorite song. So it's sort of, I can't believe this, that I know searches come up, yeah. Things you search on will pop up in here as well. But the gabapentin, I have not seriously ever done a search on it. I've never looked it up because years and years ago, long before Google, well before Google and the internet wasn't even invented, because I knew I was allergic to gabapentin 40 years ago. 40 years ago. Because that's when the pain clinic trialed me on those drugs. And it's just absolutely amazing that I can see, yeah, all the other things from searches and things like that. But why are they appearing in YouTube? Again, because I have not actually looked into it and done that. I've done searches in Google, but they're appearing in YouTube. So you've got to ask yourself, what is going on? Is it real? Why is this happening to us? And it truly is true that Google really is searching our Google phones and listening to us, to things we are saying. And as I said, the proof is in the pudding. And that is in that very first section of here, which is about the gabapentin. As I said, I've never done a search on gabapentin. And here it is. Oh, yeah, there it is. That alone tells me that I'm being listened to. That the very fact that I actually had spoken about gabapentin about 7 or 8 times, talking to the doctor what gabapentin actually did to me when I had my reaction, because that's one of the things they ask you, what it did to you, and then bang, I get a video about it. That alone tells me we are being spied on. This is wrong. And I urge everybody, now for Australians, go into my video, you will see the links to all the ministers' offices, everything like that. Use those links, contact your local members and say, why is this happening? If it is happening to you, go to your local member. Say, look, this has got to stop. This Google spying has got to stop. That means you have actually no privacy. If you have your phone with you, you have no privacy. And I've heard stories before, and I just didn't believe them. And I really didn't believe these stories, that their phones are spying on them and everything like that. And I thought, wow, it's sort of, I just thought, yeah, they don't know what they're talking about. But this to me proves it, that we are being spied on via our telephones. And it is wrong that we are being spied on. We should not be being spied on. We have a legal right to our privacy, and Google has taken that privacy away from us. To listen to somebody's conversation in any country, to record a conversation in any way, shape, or form, is against the law. Google is breaking the law. It must be stopped. And it truly must be stopped. And trust me, I'll be on the phone, because I'm a lobbyist, so I'll be on the bloody phone tomorrow in regard to this. Governments know about this, but they're just allowing this to happen. And we can't stop the things, because half of our phones have Google locks on them. We're forced to use Google as a search engine on our phones. They don't offer us any other choice for a search engine on our telephone. We've got to have Google. That's why people know them as Google phones. Any smartphone, even the Apple phones, are Google. So we do not sign up for it to listen to us and take our choices and everything, because why in the hell would a drug I'm allergic to be a choice for me? It's not. So it's got to stop, folks, and it really must stop. And I really will be on the phone to the government tomorrow, and because it's got to stop. And I'm not going to let this one go, because I have a legal right to privacy. Because each time that this spied on me today, one, I was in my bedroom. That's when the ambos turned up. Two, I was inside a sealed ambulance with the ambulance driver, having a private conversation with an ambulance driver. Then in a hospital, okay, fair enough, in a hospital it tends to be a bit less private, but it was still private information about me. Yeah, other people actually hear you talking about these things in hospital, but they don't know who you are. They're not going to send you shit about what you're talking about. Yet fucking Google does. And I don't care if you don't like the swear on YouTube, I'm fucking sick of it. And I mean, I'm fucking sick of it. And I'm telling the world to wake the fuck up and stand up and do something about Google fucking spying on us. It's wrong. In any country, any listening device, and that's what Google is currently doing. It is a listening device, and they are spying on us. They are spying on us against our fucking will, and it's got to fucking stop. And Google, trust me, I'm going to fucking sue you, and trust me, expect a lawsuit in the fucking mail for breaching my fucking privacy. It's not your right to fucking listen to me, Google. It's not your fucking right to turn around and take private fucking information about my medical fucking health and then fucking use it to give me preferences on fucking videos on another one of your fucking services. I'm going to see you dragged through the courts, Google, and I'm going to make sure the government drags you through the fucking courts. This is wrong, and it has got to fucking stop. Anyhow, subscribers, look, I'm pissed off, and because I've got a heart problem, I'm stopping this. But I had to explode, because if I had let this one go, it most probably would have put me back in fucking hospital. So, look, thanks for watching, everybody, and ring your governments up and fucking complain. There's the fucking proof right in front of you. Gabapentin and your brain health. Just that one. A drug that I'm allergic to, spoken about it numerous times today, in fucking private. And then all of a sudden I'm getting it as a video in fucking YouTube? This is fucking wrong. And I don't give a fuck, YouTube. This video is all fucking swearing because you shouldn't be fucking spying on me. Anyhow, folks, I'll catch you all later. Sorry, folks, for yelling, but there's no other way to make YouTube notice. Anyhow, thanks, everybody. Have a nice night, and I'm going to catch up to you all later. And, yeah, hopefully next time. Because if I'd let this one build up, yeah, my stress would have gone through the fucking roof. And the only way I can get rid of something is yell and fucking scream. So, sorry, folks. I'm out of here.